Hello everyone, I'm so glad you clicked on this video. But did you really click on this video right now? What if the event of you clicking on this video and watching it had been existing forever, and I mean physically existing forever, in a four-dimensional block universe? And if this is true, then everything has already happened. You've already watched this video, I already have 1 million subscribers, and all of that, it's still happening all the time. Oh gosh, that was really a lot. Let's think about it. Normally, we think of the universe as a three-dimensional space in which things change with time. There's a present moment, the current state of the universe, but the past is gone, not existing anymore. Future being an uncertain void waiting to be filled. And this works quite well. After all, what we have access to is the present. We do remember the past, but we can no longer change it. It's gone. While the future hasn't yet arrived, and so remains inaccessible until the time comes and it becomes the present, for which we'll have to wait. This view is often called presentism, in which only the present moment has a physical existence. And this was the dominant belief before relativity came and changed everything. See, the concept of past, present and future was all well and good when we could perfectly define them globally, like in Newton's framework. Time is absolute. It's like placing a giant clock in the universe that gives the measure of time for everything and everywhere and at all times. And everybody agrees to that. In such a scheme, you could perfectly describe the present as the now moment, past being moments that are lost and future being moments that are yet to come. There would be no discrepancies and everybody would agree on the temporal stuff. But our universe isn't quite as simple, because in our universe, time is relative. Objects with different velocities measure time differently. To illustrate the idea, consider two events that are simultaneous from your stationary reference frame. So for all you know, both of these events happened at the same time. They happened together. But for a moving observer, these events would not be simultaneous. Let's say if the observer is moving towards event 1, then according to him, event 1 would have occurred way before event 2 does. This is the relativity of simultaneity. Observers in relative motion do not agree on what events happen together or even the order of events. Notice that the events you observed to be simultaneous are events that, according to you, happened in one time moment. If you go back to that time, the union of all such simultaneous events are all the things you thought actually existed back then. But now you know that everybody has their own different plane of simultaneity. Two people at the same time can have widely different set of events that they call simultaneous and hence believe to actually exist at that time. You're seeing the problem here, right? If a star goes supernova, let's say for you that happened at t equal to 0, for another observer at the same place with a certain velocity away from the supernova would not have happened yet. Rather, his now would contain a fully fledged star, while for another observer at the same place with a velocity towards the supernova would have been a well past event. Now there's one thing that has to be clarified here. It's not like the three of you would see three different things happening. Rather, you all would see the same thing. After all, you all are at the same place receiving this information, so obviously you all see the same thing. However, all of your interpretation of what actually exists in your present now moment would be different. And this is where things get interesting. Fact is, we don't see in the present, we see in the past. And that's because it always takes some time for light to reach you from an event. So whatever we're seeing around us, we're seeing them as they were some very minuscule time ago. But what if the distances aren't every day? Well, then the time difference would actually become significant. It can take minutes to months, years to like millions of years for light to reach you. And then it becomes really difficult to talk about what actually exists now, because whatever we will be seeing wouldn't be a good approximation. And so, the way we figure out if something happened in your now is by waiting for the information to arrive and then thinking about and calculating at what your time it must have occurred. It's like retrospectively thinking about the timeline of events. So remember when we said that at your t equal to 0 the supernova happened? Well, you won't know that. And let's say if it takes light 2 million years to reach you from the supernova, well, then what you'll have to do is that you'll have to wait for 2 million years. 2 million years later. And now you can see the supernova, and then you can say, well, 2 million years ago, that supernova happened while I was watching a rather nice YouTube video. I hope it made sense and that you liked this video. So all the three observers would see the same thing, but because of their velocities, their definitions of what actually exists at that time, at that point, would be different. And this is where we have to think about what that implies. In relativity, one of the fundamental assumptions is that all observers are on equal footing. It's not like your frame of reference is any way more special than mine. With this knowledge, let's revisit the supernova. Forgetting about the fact that it takes light 2 million years to get to you, given the three observers, what is the state of the star now? And this is a very difficult question, because the concept of now is observer dependent, and all three of you are telling a different story. A supernova has just happened, it hasn't happened, had happened a lot earlier. How am I going to decide? Since all observers are on equal footing, we cannot say that a particular point of view is more correct or better. Rather, all of them are equally correct, and so all the three events should exist simultaneously. But then, not just the three events. In the real universe, there are an infinite number of observers. With all the possible velocities, actually, everything should exist all the time, even things that hasn't happened yet. And how can that be the case? A four-dimensional block universe. Now, what does that even mean? Imagine all of space and all of time existing as a block. Think about this way. In special relativity, time can be thought of as just another dimension, much like space is. So if space can exist all at once, why not time? This view of the entire timeline of the universe existing without there being any flow of time is often called block time. And it is sort of fascinating. Everything that has ever happened, is happening, will happen, has already happened and exists as a slice on this block universe. This block has three spatial dimensions, obviously, but in addition, there's also a time dimension. But it isn't like how we usually envision time. Rather, it is sort of another extension where consecutive moments have already been presented. Here, we are only representing two space dimensions for simplicity, and I'm also bad at animation. Interestingly, there's no motion in such a block universe. Rather, everything has taken its place and just sort of sits there. Nothing happens, nothing changes, a universe of forever stillness. So poetic. And yes, I do acknowledge the fact that all of this goes so against our intuition. If there's no flow of time, why do we feel it that way? If there's no motion happening, why do we see everything changing around us? And these are valid questions. However, we don't quite have a certain answer. Reason being, we don't fully understand how our subjective experience comes into being. At the same time, here's a nice little thought. Our perception of reality is built on how our brains make sense of all the information that is out there. What we feel comes from the information that is in our brain. And in any given slice of this block universe, there still exists all the memories and information of all the past events. The current structure of your brain essentially remembers the past even though it's gone. Similarly, your brain can provide you with a sense of flow of time because it has all the information necessary. So does that mean all of our perception of reality was a big giant illusion and the future is already there and we can't change it? Well, according to this framework, yes. But relativity isn't all that exists. You may have observed that we hadn't quite talked about quantum mechanics yet and what nature of reality can be properly understood without getting modified by the quantum stuff. And so, in our next video, we'll dive deep into how quantum mechanics changes this picture of the block universe. And I don't know how you feel about this block universe thing, but I found it really glorious. But with quantum mechanics, all hell breaks loose. Subscribe if you don't want to miss it. Where it will be out, you can find it here. Thanks for watching.